Welcome to yoga. Tonight I'm doing something a little different. I'm doing yoga in a chair just to give you some variation on our usual class. And I'd like to pick a card for us tonight. I am wise enough to know what's best for me, and I'm brave enough to act on it. And perhaps that resonates with you this evening. Maybe you could keep that in your thoughts. So finding a comfortable space, bringing yourself to your chair, allow yourself, now my chair's a little high, so I'm just gonna place a block. If you have a block, go ahead and place it underneath the feet, or you're welcome to use a book just for added support so that you have that alignment correct throughout the hips and knees. So let's just place our hands on our heart space and hands on our belly. Let's bring awareness to the breath. And begin to notice where the breath is moving freely without obstruction. And notice also any areas that you're feeling tension, tightness, or any anxiety that might be built up within the body. Just bear with me, I'm just going to turn the music down. Stay seated. Just in case that's too loud on our recording. Areas of tension and allowing yourself to breathe into this space, allowing yourself just to take a moment to soften here. You might find naturally that your breath becomes longer or your breath becomes deeper. Just notice the change in the breath. And work on lengthening the breath if you can. Bring your full awareness to the whole breath, noticing the breath as it passes through the nose, connecting to the back of the throat, allowing the chest or belly to rise slightly. Notice the sensation as you release, softening through the shoulders, through the neck, through the jaw. Inhaling again, nourishing long breath here. Allowing yourself to connect with the breath. No longer distracted by thoughts or sounds. All awareness is on the breath. And you might like to use this opportunity to introduce a mantra or a thought or an intention for your practice. Your intention could simply be joy, kindness, forgiveness, love, patience. Whatever word connects with you right now, allow yourself to just think about that word and let that word vibrate through the body. Visualize that word in your practice today. I'm beginning to draw hands to prayer and rub the hands together. Let's create a little bit of heat here. A little bit of friction. And we're going to release our hands shortly. and place them over the eyes, just 1 inch away from the eyes. So release. And just feel that heat radiating back towards your body, knowing that you're fully surrounded by warmth and love and community. And just take a moment to enjoy that warmth you've created. Drawing hands again to heart space, let's begin to lower our chin to the tops of our fingertips. You might like to open your eyes now, if you haven't done so already, gently opening the eyes. Finding a little lengthening through the back of the neck. As we release, let's take our gaze up towards the ceiling. Be mindful not to take the head too far back. We're just gently opening up through the thoracic or through the neck area. Returning your head back to neutral. Good job. We're going to bring our gaze over our left shoulder. Coming back to center, let's move over to the right side this time. And this one's quite nice if you find yourself on your phone a lot, like me, just to release any stiffness or soreness rather throughout the neck region. Come back to neutral. Let's bring that left ear towards that left shoulder. Feel that little stretch here through the side of the neck, through the scalenes. And imagine now keeping your left ear knee to your shoulder. Imagine that you're taking your eyes towards the top of your knee. So look towards the top of your knee and notice that change in the stretch of the side of the neck. Maintaining that left ear connection here. Now take your gaze up towards the ceiling. So if your eyes are closed and you're exploring this as a meditation movement, that's fine. But if your eyes are open, imagine you're looking up towards the ceiling. So take the eyes to the top corner and again notice the change in the stretch of the side of the neck. Bring yourself back to neutral. Nice. Let's move over to the right side now. Take a moment here. And now again, let's imagine that we're looking towards the top of our knee. So our gaze is coming downwards. Feel that nice deep stretch through the side of the neck. If your hands are getting tired, you can place them in your lap. And then go ahead and take your eyes up to the corner or the ceiling. Returning to neutral. Good job, welcome back. Let's place the hands on top of the lap here. Let's move through our chair. Big circles through the hips. When you come back, curl in the back, and as you come forward, lift the heart and come back around. Nice and steady here. Changing our direction. Lifting the chest. Coming back around. Just warming up through the spine, giving our abdominals a little bit of a massage here and through the hips. And a creaky chair. Good job. We're going to do another spinal roll here. So bring the chin to chest. Inhale, lift up. And as you lift up, you're growing tall through the belly and through the spine, bringing your gaze up to the ceiling. We're going to fold forward. Folding completely forward. Then bring your chin towards the chest and peel yourself up slowly, slowly. Take the gaze up. Exhale, folding forward as far as comfortable. Chin to chest. Rolling up. Two more here. Exhale, folding forward. Bring the chin to your chest. Drop the head round through the shoulders as you inhale. Coming and lengthening, growing tall. One last forward fold here. Good job. Bring the hands before heart space. Draw the arms up overhead. If you can, have the arms by the side of the ears. Soften and relax through the shoulders. We don't want to be having our shoulders all the way up here. Let's soften through the shoulders and have the arms up. Hinging forward slightly. Just slightly, so you can take the stretch into the back of the body and arms nice and strong, pointing straight up if you can, or you can be right here. But we want to make sure that we have that little hinge forward so we can be strong through the belly and strong through the back. Two more breaths here. Final breath. And release, coming back into your chair. Bring hands before heart space. Roll through the shoulders. Just once there. Good job. We're going to send the arms out and do rotations through the wrists. Just gently moving through all the joints today. Be mindful that you're not creeping up your shoulders. Let's introduce a little bit of softness through the shoulders. Changing direction. Place the hands on the palm and lengthen here. Drive the heel of the palm forward and the fingertips back. Try and get all the fingers. And then change the direction. Draw the fingers down and resist here as you push slightly forward. Change to the other hand. Place the palm there, send fingertips forward, drive that heel forward. And smile. Hopefully you're feeling quite good with this deep stretch here. Fold the fingertips down and a little bit of resistance here. You should be feeling nice and strong. Releasing here. All right, we're going to bring our hands to our shoulders. the shoulders. Take the elbows out and let's do big circles with the elbows. And we're having a nice rotation through our shoulder here. See if you can sit up nice and tall for me. And let's change our direction. I'm taking my left foot and I'm extending the leg out. Now, if you have a strap handy, I just have a strap here. You can place it on the base of your, or the arch of your foot and hold it as you bring it up. Please be careful of your knee. We want to make sure that you have a small bend in that knee so that you don't hyperextend through the knee. So just keep it a nice gentle bend here. If you don't have a strap, you can use some old leggings or anything that you can use, maybe a pair of stockings underneath the sole of the foot. Or you could just remove the strap altogether and just drive the heel. That's quite comfortable too. So just take the variation that feels most comfortable for you. Good job. And whilst that leg is extended, let's point the toes away. So this is called plantar extension. So we're planting the foot down. So point the toes away. So push the toes forward and the foot forward. You're welcome to take the knee down and just plant the foot down. And then we're going to come into dorsi. So we're bringing ourselves into dorsi, which is when the toes come up. So if our leg is extended, the heel is driving forward. If our leg is down, we just bring those toes up towards our shin. Now you should be feeling this through the shin and through the back of the leg. If you're out here, you should be feeling this through the whole leg. Good job. One more plantar. Let's plant the foot down. Returning to neutral, let's rotate through the foot. Changing our direction. Good job. Place the foot back on the floor, or if you have a high chair, which is mine is slightly, I'm placing my foot on the block. Let's take our right leg out. Stretch here, so in our dorsi here. So dorsi, I think I've got dusty feet. Pardon me. Drive the heel forward. Again, option to take the foot down and bring the toes up towards the shin. Stay here for one more breath. And as we release, we're going to plantar. So come into our plantar, point the toes down. You'll feel that activation through the calf. If your leg is extended, that's great. And again, you do have the option to use a strap if you feel more supported with the strap. Coming into dorsi, driving the heel forward. Legs starting to shake. And we're planting the foot down again. One last time here. And release. Little rotations through the ankle on both directions. Changing the direction. Good job. Let's bring that left knee into the chest. As far as comfortable for you. Soften through the shoulders. We don't want this to be a strain. We just want to support our knee as we bring it in. And we're going to release that. right leg knee in and bring it into the chest. It might be there for you that you can bring the knee all the way in, but we'll just take it to where it feels comfortable for you today. Let's just take it easy today. Let's take our left foot, bring it up, hold the leg if you need to, and place that foot on top of your right knee. Get yourself feeling comfortable. If you need support, you can place a pillow underneath that bent knee if you feel that you need the support. If not, just keep it here. What we'd like to do here is apply a little bit of pressure here, not too much, just a wee bit of pressure here. And we're going to sit nice and tall and draw in the belly and lift the chest. Soften through the shoulders and jaw. And just a little pressure here so that we can open through the inner thigh and through the hip flexors. So let's stay here. You might like to close down the eyes and explore this movement with your eyes closed. Check in with your breath. Notice any change to the breath. And where can we find more length in our breath? Maybe you can introduce a little bit more length to the breath. Good job. Keeping that knee and foot where it is, let's do little circles here. Same principle as before, let's lift the chest forward and tuck in the ribs as we curl back, lifting up, tucking and rounding. Changing direction. Nice little circles here. Good job. Let's just massage through the toes, holding onto the toes in just little circles here. Support your leg as you take it back down to the block or to the ground. Let's take up our right knee. Place the foot here. Now I'm feeling a little bit tighter on this side of my body, so you notice that my knee comes up a little higher. And that's fine, it just may mean I need a bit of support. Now I can place a ball under there because I had one handy, but you might have a pillow or a rolled up towel to support you here. So I'm just using this ball because it was handy, and I'm going to apply a little bit of pressure here just to introduce some flexibility here through my tight hip on my right side body. Close down the eyes if it's there for you and if you feel comfortable to do so. Final breath here. Good job. As you release, let's lift the chest forward, little circles here, nothing too grand or big. It's really subtle and gentle rotation through the hip. Changing your direction here. The hands on the toes. Let's just little circles with the toes in one direction and then let's change. A few creaks and cracks, that's fine. Support your leg as you return to the block. Alrighty, we're going to take our left leg. leg, excuse me, out to the side. So if you can turn on your chair, go ahead and do so. Take our right leg out to the side. Keep seated. And let's extend that back left leg. We want to keep our bottom on the chair here as we move over to the side. Now, in this time, we're looking towards the left side. Let's draw the arms up by the side body. Good. Now, just take this as far as you feel comfortable. You might not have the range, or it might be a bit tender through the hips. So you might need to keep that back knee bent. But let's just turn here, keep that foot, pardon me, on our block so that we have that proper alignment and you can have your arms up here. Or you can take your variation and send the leg back. So this is our warrior one, feeling strong and supported. Bring your awareness to the breath. Soften through the shoulders. Begin to take the palm, the right palm, towards the back of the room. Just fix my pants up. Pardon me. Let's take the right palm towards the back of the room. This brings us to our warrior two. Keep looking towards the left side of the room. And we're going to take that left palm up towards the ceiling and look up towards the ceiling and gently drop that back palm down. Remember, you do have the option of having that back knee bent. This is completely fine and safe. Just looking up towards the ceiling, taking our arm with our gaze towards the ceiling. As you return that left hand to the top of the knee, support yourself as you bring yourself back into a seated position. I'm moving my block to the other side as this chair is a bit tall for me, and I'm coming over to the right side. So, placing my right foot on top of my block. You might not have a need for a block. If you can reach the floor, I have small legs. All right, option one here is to have that back knee down. Supported and seated on the chair, draw arms up overhead. Option two is to straighten as comfortably as possible that back leg. Take your variation here, whichever you want to explore. I'm going to demonstrate this way so that you can get an idea of how it could be. And I hope you are feeling comfortable here. And feeling strong. Let's open up. Take the left palm now towards the left side of the room. The right palm is forward and we're gazing to the right side. Take that right palm up towards the ceiling. Take the left palm down and bring the gaze and the right palm up. A very gentle back bend. Just bringing our gaze up toward the ceiling. Good job. Returning to neutral. Place the hands on the knee. Support yourself as you bring yourself back to your seated position. All right. Let's take the arms up overhead this time. I'm taking my palm around my wrist. So arm up, lift up here, growing tall through the spine. So imagine something is pulling you through the crown of the head and you're holding onto your wrist. And we're gently moving over to the left side body. Just a gentle stretch here. yourself back towards your intention or your mantra, whatever word you chose at the beginning of your practice. I like to invite that word into your practice now. Kindness, patience, love, forgiveness, joy, whatever word you chose. Allow it to resonate here with you and really visualize that word. Coming back to center, let's change our palm. Grow tall, imagine the crown of the head. You're creating length in the spine and the belly. And then we're coming over right side body. Bring yourself back to center, hands before heart space. Let's inhale together. Draw the arms up. Bring yourself into a gentle twist, left side body. Stay here for three breaths. Noticing that the longer you stay, maybe you can find a deeper twist. Final breath here. And release. Coming back to center. Hands before heart. Inhale, growing tall. Exhale, opening right side body. Release, coming back to center, hands before heart space. Just take a little bit of movement, whatever you feel that you might need to bring yourself into a comfortable seated position. And take a moment here to return to the breath. Visualizing the breath as it passes through the nostril. Connects softly to the back of the throat. The belly or chest gently rises. And as you exhale, shoulders fall away from the ears and introducing a state of calm and connectedness to breath. Four more breaths here in your own time, taking a deep and slow inhalation, nourishing the body, and as you exhale, releasing any tension, tightness, anything that no longer serves you. Allow yourself to release it on your exhalation. Three more here. Final breath here. a moment to return to your normal breath cycle now. No longer lengthening the breath. Drawing hands before heart space. Let's just acknowledge the time that you've dedicated to yourself and your mental health and your healthy body. And take the time to appreciate your body for its strength and wellness. Thank you so much for sharing your energy with me today. I really appreciate having you join me on this journey. Let us draw our hands to our third eye, our mouth, and our heart. May you speak to yourself and others with kindness and compassion. Gently lower the head, and if you like, I invite you to share with me. Namaste. Thank you so much for having me. I hope that you are feeling well and rested and healthy and stretched. And I really look forward to sharing more yoga with you.